tabernacle of God, the sacrifices of joy. I will sing, yes, I will sing praises to the Lord. You are my source, you are my strength, you are my shield, you are my buckler, you are my rear guard, you are my shield upon my right hand. You are Lord, you are my sun, the brightness of my glory, my God, my guide, my Lord, my King, my fortress, my future, my past, my present. In you I live and move and have my being. Yes, you were. Yes, you were. Yes, you were. Lord, we worship you. We give you all the glory. Sometimes you got to remember who God has been to you. You got to remind yourself of who He is. The Lord is my life.
And my salvation. Whom shall I fear?
Whom shall I fear?
Whom shall I fear? You are my strength.
And you are my reward.
My reward.
The solid rock upon which I stand.
Welcome, dear viewer. This morning is a wonderful day that the Lord has made, that we may rejoice and be glad in it. So I welcome you each morning. We pray from Monday to Friday. In our prayer meets, we seek God when we can still do so. So I welcome you. Join me this morning so that we may make our way right with God as we move into our daily activity. Just join me as we thank God for a wonderful day. This is the day that He has made that we may rejoice. And so, God, we thank you this morning for the gift of life and the gift of a new day. In the name of Jesus, we are grateful. We are grateful and happy that we are sober. You called us from a deep sleep, O God, that we may come, O Father, over and do the activities of this day. We pray in Jesus' name that you be with us, O God. Thank you for our children. Thank you for our land. Thank you for the bread of life. Thank you for thy anointing. Thank you for your grace. Thank you for your goodness over this day. In whatever we do, we thank you for the strength to move. We thank you for the strength to be productive. We thank you for all that you have for us today. Dear Lord, we worship you. You reign on high. You take charge over our lives, and whatever we do today, our life shall never be the same again, because you are the one that determines the result. We worship you. Take your first place in our life, because you are the beginning and the end. We bless you and we honor you, for you are great and greatly to be praised, and there is no other God like unto thee. So be magnified and be lifted, for you are mighty and there is nothing that you cannot do. In Jesus' name, amen. And so, dear viewer, turn with me to the book of Lamentation, chapter 3, verses 23. Lamentation, chapter 3, verses 23. And it says, let's start from verse 22. It is of the Lord's mercies that we are not consumed, because his compassion faileth not. Verse 23, they are new every morning, and great is thy faithfulness. And I want us to pray out of that scripture this morning, that the Lord will direct his mercies towards you, towards me, towards us, towards our children, because his mercies are new each morning. So join me to ask God, who is able to show us mercy when your parents, when your bosses, when the people that you think should help you are out of your way, they cannot show up. Ask God that he may show you mercy this morning, so that this day may go well with you. Father, we thank you in the name of Jesus. You are a wonderful God. You are a great I am. We thank you because you have given us your word to show us the direction of your will, and also to reveal unto us what you have for us. This morning we know that your mercies are new each morning, and because they don't fail, so we come before you in Jesus' name, that may you direct your mercy in whatever we do in the name of Jesus. For your mercies are new each morning. We trust in you. We bless you because you are a wonderful God. We magnify your name. We praise the awesome God. Have, O Lord, your way in our life, and may you direct your mercies in whatever we do in the name of Jesus Christ. Your mercies upon our path, your mercies in our marriages, your mercies in the business that you are doing, your mercies, O God, upon our parents, your mercies upon our leaders in the name of Jesus, your mercies towards this nation in the name of Jesus. We thank you. But because of your mercy, we shall not falter. Because of your mercy, we shall not lose course. Because of your mercy, we shall overcome in the name of Jesus, that we are forgiven. Because of your mercy, you re-strengthen us. Because of your mercy, you visit us. Because of your mercy, God, we thank you for your mercies that are new towards us this morning. I praise thy name and I lift you up on high. In Jesus' name, cover your people with your mercy, God. Cover us with your mercies this morning. Oh God, in every activity, in Jesus' name, manifest your mercies over us, oh God, in every turn of our life. In Jesus' name, we give you praise and we lift you up on high because you are able. I pray your mercies over our doctors in this nation, oh God. Cover them, oh God, from any attack of the enemy. In Jesus' name, show them your mercies, God, in the name of Jesus. People that are on the weaker side, Lord, I pray that your help be on their side. Show them your kindness and your mercies that doesn't fail. We bless you because you are a faithful God and you will not fail us. So we love you and we adore you because you are God with us. In Jesus' name, our God, how we pray and give thanks. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Turn with me to the book of Genesis chapter 42. Genesis chapter 42. Genesis chapter 42. This is when there was drought in the land. And chapter 42 from verse 1. This time there was drought in the land. And the Bible says, verses 1, that now when Jacob saw that there was corn in Egypt, Jacob said unto his sons, why do you look one upon another? And he said, behold, I have heard that there is corn in Egypt. Get you down thither and buy for us from thence that we may live and not die. This time there was a problem. There was no food enough for the people of the house of Jacob, but there was food in Egypt. I want us to pray this morning that the Lord will give us power to produce what we need. Will give you power to produce what you need. You don't have to be a beggar. The Bible says in the book of Ecclesiastes chapter 5 verses 9 that the wealth and the riches of the earth is available to all. So why should somebody else be able to produce food and you lack? So I want us to pray that God will give us grace to produce enough food, to produce solution for ourselves, that you will not be tossed to and fro. Join me in prayer. God is able, my brother and my sister. God, we thank you. In the name of Jesus, you are the giver of all strength. You are the possessor of skills and wisdom. And so we come before your throne this morning, God, because we know, we understand, we are convicted, we are persuaded that what we are asking you are also able to do it in the name of Jesus Christ. And therefore, Father God, we ask you for grace and wisdom to use the available resources to produce our own answer, to produce our own solution, to produce our own bread, that we will not be beggars in the same land, oh God, will not become slaves to the possessors of bread. Well, the available resources is for all. We pray in Jesus' name, the ability to recognize, oh God, the potential that is around us, resources that are around us, oh God, and ability, wisdom to turn them into answers, to turn them into bread in the name of Jesus. Jesus Christ. The Bible said that you beat your plowshares and to weapon. I pray that whatever we possess, we will be able to use it, oh God, to solve problems around us in the name of Jesus, to meet our needs, oh God, in the name of Jesus, that will not starve and run to people, oh God, that can do what we also can do. I pray in Jesus' name that whatever is lacking in our life, may you make it available by your Spirit in the name of Jesus. Father, I thank you. You strengthen my viewer. I thank you because you are helping my viewer. You are helping our brothers. You are helping me. You are helping the church. You are helping this nation in the name of Jesus, that none of us shall cry. None of us shall be weak. None of us shall be vulnerable to the predators. Oh God, I pray because you are God who is able to do much more than we can expect. So we bless you. Awesome God, have your way. In Jesus' name, empower the weak. In Jesus' name, empower the weak. Oh God, supply wisdom, supply resources, supply whatever we need, because you are not limited in resources. I thank you. In Jesus' name, it is written that our God is able to supply all according to his riches in glory. So we approach your throne of mercy in Jesus' name, because you are able to supply much more than we need, much more than we require. In the mighty name of Jesus, awesome God, you are worthy. We bless you, mighty warrior, great in battle. No one else is like unto thee. Have your way. Raise the standard of the lives of your people. In the name of Jesus, cause us, oh God, to produce bread. Teach our hands how to produce answers in the name of Jesus, that we shall never be slaves, oh God, to people who carry bread. In the name of Jesus, teach our hands to produce our own corn. Teach our hands. You are the one that teaches our hand, oh God, to profit in the name of Jesus, to produce victory in the name of Jesus Christ. I pray, my Father and my God, that you teach our hands to produce solution, to produce answers in the name of Jesus. We worship you for what a wonderful God you are, the God, the possessor of all power, the possessor of all grace, the possessor of all wisdom. We bless your name. We adore you in the name of Jesus, the God of all possibility. Behold, we praise thee. We lift you up on high. We adore you, for you reign now and forevermore. My Master, I thank you in Jesus' name that from now onwards you hear our prayer, oh God, and answer in Jesus' name. For you said that the day that we shall call on your name, so shall you answer us. So we bless you, awesome God. Have your way, oh God. Do and perform miracle by giving, oh Lord, my viewer, oh Jehovah God, whatever they need, so that they shall be productive. In Jesus' name, we worship you and we lift you up on high, for you are the one that is with us. So we are not destroyed. Our King and our Father, be magnified and be lifted up in the name of Jesus Christ, we pray and give thanks. Amen. Amen. Turn with me to the book of Psalms 27, verses 11, 27, verses 11 and 13. Psalms chapter 27, verses 11 to 13. 27, the book of Psalms. And it says, verse 11, teach me thy way, O Lord, and lead me in a plain path because of mine enemies. Deliver me not over unto the will of mine enemies, for false witnesses are risen up against me, and such as breath out cruelty. I have fainted unless I had believed to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. I want us to pray this morning that the Lord will teach us his ways. The Bible says that there is a path that seems good in our eyes, but it leads to destruction. I want us to pray that the Lord will teach you, will teach me, will teach us his ways, that we may not fall into wrong hands. And so that as we continue in our daily activity, that the Lord will continually teach us his ways. And so join me as we ask the God, the author of the universe, the one that created you, the one that knows what you need in this life, the one that knows what's gonna work for you. In Jesus' name, Father, we pray that you teach us, oh God, you teach us, oh God, we teach you, teach us, make us become your student, Holy Spirit. Father God, Lord Jesus, we are your student and we submit to your teaching this day. We submit to your counsel. We submit, oh God, to your teaching. Teach us your ways. Teach us your ways. Teach us your ways, oh God. Teach us your ways, oh God. Oh Father, as we walk in this life, oh God, teach us your ways. In the name of Jesus, teach us your directions. Teach us your ways, oh God. Teach us the path, oh God, that we should take in the name of Jesus Christ, that we shall not go astray, that we shall not go wrong course. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Teach us your ways. Teach us your ways. That we shall not be persuaded by the events of life, oh God, but we're going to follow your ways. Teach us your ways in the name of Jesus. Each morning, each day, at noontime, in the evening, teach us your ways, dear Father. Teach us your ways. Teach me your ways. Teach me your ways, that I may not go astray. In Jesus' name, teach me your ways, Father God. Teach me your ways. Teach me your ways, how to do things, how to operate, oh God, excellently, how to do things in your will, in your plan. God, teach me your ways in the name of Jesus, I pray. Teach me your ways, oh God, this day. Teach me your ways. I am your student. I don't know all things, but you are all knowing. So I pray that you teach me your ways, because I've never been in this day before. I don't know the way, oh God, that's going to give me success. I don't know the way to victory. I don't know the way to life. I don't know the way, oh God, to productivity. I pray that you teach me your ways, oh God, and teach my viewer your ways, oh God, and teach us your ways, oh God, in the name of Jesus Christ, that none of us shall go astray, that none of us shall lose course, that none of us shall be persuaded by the sideshows around us. In the name of Jesus, teach us your ways, oh God, for we look up unto you, the author and the finisher of our faith. Dear God, I thank you that you are with us. And therefore we shall walk in your ways, our God. For you are the mighty one of Israel, who never fail us. Be magnified in Jesus' name. In the same verse of 11, of Psalms 27, verse 11, the second part of it says that, the Father said that, teach me thy way, O Lord, and lead me in a plain path because of mine enemies. Lead me in a plain path because of mine enemies. And I want us to pray out of that second part of it, that the Lord will make it easy for us to proceed forth. He will make it easy for us and for you to move forward. Make it easy for you and for us to move forward, to achieve our goal, to run our race, to fulfill our purpose. I want you to join me as we ask God. He is the Almighty God, the one that is in charge over all things that you are looking for. God, we pray in the name of Jesus that you make our path be plain before our eyes. Remove every barrier, mountain. Remove every, oh God, red seas. Remove every threatening things on our path. Make it easy for us, oh God, in the name of Jesus Christ. Make it easy for us to operate in this day. Make it easy for us to profit this day. Make it easy for us to execute our assignment this day. Make it easy for us to achieve over the expected result today. In the name of Jesus, make it easy for us to connect with our customers and clients today. Make it easy, God, for us to achieve our purpose. Make it easy for us to achieve our goal this year. Make it easy for us, oh God, to live long. Make it easy for us to fulfill our purpose. Make it easy for us to pursue our dream in life. Father, in Jesus' name, you are mighty warrior, God of all possibility. There is nothing that you cannot do. How we pray in the name of Jesus, make it easy, God, for my viewer, in the name of Jesus, make it easy for them in that marriage. Make it easy for them, oh God, in this life, then that are staying in the city, I pray that you make it easy for them to stay in the city. In the name of Jesus, give them what to do. In the name of Jesus, make it easy for them, oh God, to pay rent. Make it easy for them, oh God, to have a healthy life. Make it easy for them to pay their bills. In the name of Jesus, I pray. God of Almighty, I pray in Jesus' name. Make it easy for us to succeed. Make it easy for us to go through. Make it easy for us to win our battles. Make it easy. Make it easy. Make it easy, God. In Jesus' name, give us your aid. Ishadabosha Pradekaya Namaha. We pray in Jesus' name. Make it easy. You who give aids to men, I pray. Ibabosha Gadaboha Madakashaha. Make it easy. Make it easy, dear Lord. In the name of Jesus, that it shall not be burdensome. It shall not be a struggle. The Bible says, and the commandments of the Lord are not burdensome. I pray that what you are commanding us to do shall not be burdensome. Oh God, make it easy for the ministers that you have called to represent you, oh God, on earth. Make it easy for pastors, apostles, also prophets, and any other person that you have called for the work of the kingdom. I pray that make it easy in the name of Jesus Christ, because you are the Lord our helper. For if you don't help us, God, there is no help elsewhere. And so we run to you, Jesus, that you're going to make it easy. In the name of Jesus, we bless you and we honor you, for you are a mighty warrior. There is none like unto thee. Be exalted and be lifted up on high. In Jesus' name, Father, we pray and give thanks. In Jesus' name. Turn with me to the book of Proverbs chapter 24 verses 10. Proverbs 24 verses 10. Proverbs 24 verses 10. Proverbs 24 verses 10. And it says, if thou faint in the day of adversity, thy strength is small. If thou faint in the day of adversity, thy strength is small. And I want us to pray in this season. We are in a season of trial. We are in a season of tempting. But I want us to pray that God will give us his strength to stand the test of the enemy. God will give us strength and will give you strength to overcome, that you will not falter, you will not succumb to the threats of the enemy, to the arrows of the enemy, that you will be strong. God will supply you with strength. The Bible says that he is our strengthener. It says also that we can do all things through Christ who strengthens us. I want us to pray for strength to move on, strength to overcome challenges, strength to outrun the hands and the effort of the enemy that are standing and raising against your life, against your business, against your marriage, against this land, against your health. The Lord will give you strength in Jesus' name. And so, God, we pray to you because you are almighty. There is nothing that you cannot do. I pray this morning that you fill us with strength. In the name of Jesus, load us with strength. In Jesus' name, load us with strength. Load us with strength. Load us with strength. Strength to overcome. Strength to overcome challenges of this season. Challenges of marriages. Challenges in business. Challenges of the calling. Challenges in ministry. We pray in the name of Jesus for strength. Renew our strength to overcome. You are the one, the supplier of strength, who giveth strength to the faint, who giveth power to the weak. And so we pray in Jesus' name that you load us with strength, emotional strength, physical strength, spiritual strength. In the name of Jesus, I pray that
you strengthen our immunity, that it shall overcome every challenges that are directed towards our health. In the name of Jesus, that COVID-19 shall not over bring us down. In the name of Jesus, we shall not falter in this particular time. I pray in Jesus' name for the members of our church, oh God. I pray in Jesus' name, even for the leaders of this nation. I pray even for the land of Kenya. I pray for the house of faith in the entire world. I pray in the name of Jesus for our relatives and friends. I pray for workmates. I pray for business people. I pray, oh God, for people in different positions. In Jesus' name, that your strength be upon them. In Jesus' name, I pray for the floodgate of strength, oh God, to rain upon us. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name, for the devil open, no one can close. I pray that you open the floodgate of heaven. Let your strength flow upon our body, upon our mind, upon our health. In Jesus' name, upon our spirit. In the name of Jesus, we lift you up on high. We pray for your strength upon our doctors. We pray for your strength upon our leaders. We pray for your strength upon our seniors, our pastors, in the name of Jesus, our bishops, in the name of Jesus. We pray for your strength upon the church of Christ, upon the body of Christ, in the name of Jesus Christ. We pray your strength upon even the county leaders, in the name of Jesus Christ. We pray for your strength in the business field, in Jesus' name, upon our children, in the name of Jesus, our parents, even the vulnerable, the elderly. I pray your strength to keep them standing, to keep them strong, to keep them standing, in the name of Jesus, that they will overcome the trial and the test of this season, in Jesus' name. Your strength in our faith, our God, in Jesus' name, for you are God and there is no other God like unto thee. Be magnified, be lifted up on high, for you are the great I am. I worship you and I praise thee, for you are mighty warrior, great in battle, and there is nothing that you cannot do. My master, I praise thee, for you are on our side. So be exalted and be lifted up in Jesus' name. We worship you, we give you praise in Jesus' name. Amen, amen. And lastly, for us to go to the book of Ezekiel chapter 1. Ezekiel chapter 1, from verse 1. Ezekiel chapter 1, verses 1. Ezekiel chapter 1, verses 1. And it says, now it came to pass in the 13th year, in the fourth month, in the fifth day of the month, as I was among the captives by the river of Cheba, that the heavens were opened, and I saw visions of God. Verse 2, in the fifth day of the month, which was the fifth year of King Joachim's captivity, the word of the Lord came expressly unto Ezekiel the priest, the son of Buzi, in the land of the Chaldean by the river Cheba, and the hand of the Lord was there upon him. And I want us to pray, that irrespective of challenges of the season, that God will open your eyes to see good things that he is doing in your life. This time, Ezekiel and other Jewish community were in captivity. But even in the captivity, God opened heaven for him, and he was able to see visions. There are things that you will start seeing. There are things that God will open your eyes to see. So don't only focus on the things that are not working. But I want us to pray this morning that God will redirect your focus on the things that are working for you, so that you'll be able to channel your strength, your energy into that direction. Don't just give your time to the part of you that is failing. failing, when you ignore the other side that is working for you. I want us to pray. I want us to pray that God will open your eyes to see, to recognize, to see the things that God is doing in your life. So don't just look at Eleazar as your inheritor. Don't just look at the captivity hand that is holding you. There are many other things that God is doing in your life, if only you can look around. And so, Father, we pray in the name of Jesus. This morning, you are the God, the light that causes our eyes to see in blindness, the opener of our eyes, the sight giver, the blind eyes, the blind people. Bartimaeus called on your name and you opened his eyes. The disciples ate bread and their eyes were open. I pray that you open our eyes to recognize the good things that you are doing in the name of Jesus, that our mind will not be taken captive by the perceptions of the enemy, by the works of Satan. In the name of Jesus, I pray for my viewer that you are opening his eyes to see the things that you're doing in his life, in her life, in their lives. In the name of Jesus, the paths that are working in Jesus' name, I pray, my Father, that as you open our eyes today, that we will be able to see the good things that you are doing in our lives. In the name of Jesus, behold, the Bible says that, behold, you are doing new things. You are doing wonderful things in our life, things that are encouraging. I pray in Jesus' name for open heaven. I pray for visions. I pray in Jesus' name for the express word, Rema, the words that give direction. In the name of Jesus, I pray that we shall receive the word of the Lord, that the viewer will be able, oh God, to see what you are doing in their life. In Jesus' name, I pray in the name of the Lord that you are doing great things, and we worship you, for you alone you are worthy. Be, oh God, magnified. Be lifted up, O some God. Be glorified, O Father, because you are great and greatly to be praised. We magnify you. We lift you up on high in Jesus' name. As you open our eyes, as you open our eyes of understanding, that we may be able to see your goodness in our life, your mercies in our lives, your favor in our life, the opportunities that you are giving us, the strength that you have given unto us, the peace of God in our life, the healing of God in our life. And so we worship you, we praise thee, because you are the great I am. Be magnified, be lifted, O some God. We thank you, for you are faithful, and your faithfulness runs from generation to generation. Dear Father, we thank you for hearing and honoring our prayer this morning. Be magnified and be all exalted, for you are God, and there is none like unto thee. My heart rejoices in thee, that there is no any other God apart from you. You are trustworthy. And so we put our hope and our trust in you, that you have answered our prayer. In Jesus' name, amen and amen and amen. Thank you, dear viewer, for being with me in this those few minutes, oh God, that we were praying. And so I appreciate your time so much, and we are stepping into another level of hearing the word of God. I want you, if possible, wherever you are, just keep on your phone and let's share the word of the Lord. For this is the bread of life that will give strength and life to your knees, to your body, to your mind, and to your spirit. Because this word is able to give you an inheritance. Some of us, we don't have an inheritance elsewhere, but the word of God has given us a portion. So join me as we share the word of God this morning. And we go to the book of Luke chapter 10. Luke chapter 10. Luke chapter 10. In the next few minutes, I just want to share with us some few things in the book of Luke chapter 10 from verse 30. Luke chapter 10 from verse 30. All right. Luke chapter 10 from verse 30. My Bible says that, "And Jesus answering said a certain man went down from Jerusalem to Jericho and fell among thieves, which stripped him of his raiment and wounded him and departed, leaving him half dead. Verses 31. And by chance there came down a certain priest that way. And when he saw him, he passed by on the other side. And likewise a Levite, when he was at the place, came and looked on him and passed by on the other side. But a certain Samaritan, as he journeyed, came where he was, and when he saw him, he had compassion on him, and went to him, verse 34, and bound up his wounds, pouring in oil and wine, and set him on his own beast, and brought him to an inn, and took care of him. And on the morrow, when he departed, he took out 2 pence and gave them to the host, and said unto him, take care of him, and whatsoever thou spendest more, when I come again, I will repay thee. That is verse 35. It is a story from verse 30 to 35. Jesus was giving a story about a good Samaritan, as we, most of us, know the story. On top of it, it's always written, a good Samaritan. I want us to learn some few things out of this scripture. The Bible says from verse 30 that, and Jesus answering and said, a certain man went down from Jerusalem to Jericho and fell among thieves. There are a few things I want to pull out of that. A certain man went down from Jerusalem to Jericho. Jerusalem means a house of bread. Jerusalem means a house of bread. And this man was coming from Jerusalem, the house of bread, to Jericho. You remember Jericho was cursed by Joshua. Jericho was a cursed place. Now he's coming from the house of bread towards Jericho, a cursed place. When Joshua said that, let nobody raise the walls of Jericho again. Now, this means that sometimes we make decisions in life that result to casualties, that result to some things in our life that are not good. And this scripture teaches us that God's view or God's mind in this is that there are places that God has placed us, that we should get our bread there, that we should prosper there. But if we make decision to move into places that he has not put our bread, then we will start becoming vulnerable. We will be attacked because we don't have his covering. We don't have his protection. When the moment he moved from Jerusalem and starting going into the direction of Jericho, he was exposed to attack because there was no covering. Everybody has got a particular perimeter that God designed for them to prosper therein. Amen. God had planned for us even before we were born, and he knows what he had put in us. There are atmospheres that when we move into, what we have shall die. We become weak. But there are places that when we are there, we prosper, we increase, we do well. So the man is coming from Jerusalem, the house of plenty, towards Jericho, a cursed place. Before you move, dear listener, please seek from the Lord. David had this in his mind always. Whenever he was supposed to make a step, he would seek the mind of God first. So seek it from God. Don't just move. So that when you fall into the hands of the enemy is when you start seeking God. That's why we pray in the morning like this. Before we start any daily activity, we first of all seek God so that he will direct us. He will direct our course. He will show us and teach us his ways so that we don't go by our own mind, by our own emotion. Amen. Don't just move. Seek God. Seek His will for the day. Seek His plan for the day. Ask Him, what do you want me to do? Which direction do you want me to take? Where should I get my bread today? Because if you turn to wrong people, they will hurt you. They will hurt you. So many people are wounded because they went to wrong people, asking for what they need, and those people didn't have it. You know? So it is important for us, it is important for you, dear viewer, that before you make a step, you seek the direction of God for your life. Be it marriage, be it business, be it seeking job, you ask God. You don't have to waste a lot of time. You just seek God and He will direct your course. The Bible says that He ordered the steps of a righteous man. But you must ask for him to order your steps. Amen. So seek God. The guy moved from Jerusalem. I mean, the man was moving from Jerusalem towards Jericho. Before you move, seek the mind of God. Seek the ways of God so that He may be with you. He said that you shall hear a voice telling you that this is the way. Follow you it. And it is only going to happen if you seek it from the Lord. Because God will not impose Himself into your life. You seek Him. You seek Him. He will be found. Amen. Amen. So the man moved from Jerusalem to Jericho and fell among thieves, which stripped him of his raiment. Many of us, we are moving. Maybe you are moving from point A to point B, one place to another. Movement is there all over. People move from Africa to Europe. People move from Europe to America, Asia, different places. People are moving. People move. But if God does not direct you, then you will fall into wrong hands. You will fall into people that will just hurt you and con you. Amen. So, this teaches us the first thing that we learn here is that before we make a move, we need to seek the direction of God and to know that He is with us in the direction that we are taking, in the decisions that you are making, in the actions that we are taking, in the steps. God, if God be with you, then you shall overcome. But if you've not sought after His mind, then who will advocate for you? Because along the way, the enemies are along the way. Some will discourage you. But if you have God, He will strengthen you. He will confirm His word. He will give you the word of an assurance. He will give you the word of an assurance. He gave Paul the word of an assurance when there was turbulence. He said that you will not falter into this turbulence because you must show yourself on the other side before King Agrippa. You must show yourself there before judges on the other side. So God will give you the word of an assurance. God, if you sought Him first, if you seek Him first, so you need to seek God before you make a move, because the enemies are along the path. The enemies are along the way that you are taking. But if you have God, He will be your defense, He will cover you, and He will protect you. He said that, and he fell among thieves, and I pray that you will not fall into wrong hands. I pray for you that because you have sought God with me this morning, you will not fall into wrong hands. You will not fall into people whose idea or whose thoughts are just to cut you down. You will not fall into wrong hands. Your dreams will not fall into wrong ears. You see, Joseph told his dream to his brothers. And those who are wrong ears, the moment they heard it, they planned on how to kill him, to cut short his vision. And I pray for you, because you have sought the Lord with me, that the Lord will protect your dream. He will protect your vision. He will protect your desires. And the enemy shall not have access. The Bible says that, and the sower sowed a seed, and as he was throwing, some fell and upon the rock. It was exposed, and the birds of the air came and took it. I pray that your dream, your vision, your desires will not fall into such wrong places. So the Lord will protect you and direct your landing. He will direct your landing. He will direct your landing. He will direct you, connect you with people, right people, that will be able to accommodate and support what you carry. Will hold you up, will keep you standing, will strengthen you, will add into you ideas that will make you succeed in the field that the Lord has ordained you into. Amen. The word of the Lord is sweet unto me this morning. And he fell among thieves, who stripped him of his raiment and wounded him and departed, leaving him half dead. Stripped him. And this means covering. We all need the cover of God. We all need the cover of God. We all need the cover of God. Jesus said that without me, you can do nothing. And the enemy is roaring like a lion, looking for who to devour. You know, the devil is moving around there. The enemy is moving around there. So do not be cheated by anybody that you don't need God. You need God in your walk. You need God at night. You need God at day, because there are arrows. Psalms 91 says that there are arrows that flies by day. There are arrows that flies by night. So you need God, so that when you are asleep, he still covers you. When you are asleep, he will still cover you. When you are in a matatu, he still covers you. When you are in the, in hospital, treating and taking care of those who have been affected, the Lord can still cover you. You need his covering, so that the weapons of the enemy cannot access your health, cannot access your dream, cannot access your desires, and cannot access the call of God in your life. Not even your marriage. Because if God covers you, in the book of Job, the devil tried so many times, chapter 1, and he confessed that the Lord, you have made an edge of protection around Job. And so I have tried, I could not access. The moment God lifted his covering, Job was exposed to destruction. And I pray that the Lord will cover you. He will cover you in the morning. He will cover you at noontime. He will cover you at night. He will cover you in all season. If you have his covering, as long as his covering is upon you, then COVID-19 will mean nothing. It will not affect you. The events that have been orchestrated by the enemy to frustrate people around will not reach you, because you have the covering of God Almighty. But so they removed and fell among thieves, which stripped him of his raiment and wounded him and departed, leaving him half dead. They had to remove the covering before they attacked him. The devil asked God, Satan asked God, that remove the covering, so after that I will be able to attack him. You know, when God covers you, the enemy has got no access. The enemy will not have access over your children, because you submit to God's covering. Because you submit to God's covering. Don't be a lone ranger. The moment you start walking alone, The moment you think that you don't need the help of God, the moment that you feel like now you are strong enough, the moment that you feel that you have a covering of money, you have a covering of human wisdom, you have a covering of human philosophy, you are learned, you have some certificates around, you have some companies around, man, that will be the beginning of your falling. That will be the beginning of your falling. So, submit to God and His covering, and He will hold you up. He will hold you up. Don't say that you don't need God. But say only a fool say that there is no God. So, don't agree with people or others that are thinking in that direction. They are out of course because there is God. The evidence is obvious to everyone. The evidence is obvious to everyone. You did not call yourself from a sleep. It is God who called you up. You didn't know where you are, but God called you up. The evidence is obvious. Even that sleep, you did not buy it. The evidence is obvious. So do not lie to yourself that there is no God. There is God, and that's why we worship Him. And when He gives you His covering, you will be safe. You will be safe. Your children will be protected. Your business, your marriage will be protected from the attacks and the arrows of the enemy. And I pray that you will be safe because you submit to God. Amen. Hallelujah. Let's continue a little bit. In the next few minutes, I will be done. But let's learn some few things. Fell among thieves, who stripped him of his raiment and wounded him and departed, leaving him half dead. 31. And by chance there came down a certain priest that way, and when he saw him, he passed by on the other side. Now, I want to tell you the reason why we always pray in the morning. Why men always ought to pray. So that you may not be ignorant. Also that you may not just think that things are... And by chance there came down a certain priest that way. And when he saw him, he passed by on the other side. When you are in need and you ask God, God always sends answers. God always have people that He sends for your rescue, that He sends to feed you, that carry the answers that you need. But along the way, the enemy divert them. The enemy create a negative picture. And so they don't reach out to you. That's why we must always continue in prayer. The Bible says that men always ought to pray. Men always ought to pray. There was a widow, and as she continued in prayer, the judge could not resist her request. You always ought to pray because the enemy take captive the minds of people that are supposed to help you and create a negative picture. But when you pray, God removes that mentality. God steps in and restores back things to order. And those people are able to reach you. I may not go any further because of time, dear viewer. But I want us to learn. I want us to keep what we have learned in our heart. Because it will help us along the way. It will help us along the way. There are people that God has given what you need. There are people that God has given answers that you requested. God does not hold things that you need in heaven. His desire is to help you and to answer the request that you have made to Him. But the enemy is in between the answer and you. He gave answer to an angel in the book of Daniel. But the prince of Persia took captive the angel, and the angel that carried the answer could not reach Daniel. But Daniel continued in prayer. So each morning pray, and God will step in your situation. Maybe the answer is held up somewhere and the enemy diverted and to another side, just the way he diverted Jonah. In Jonah chapter 1, he was given an answer to people of Nineveh, but he chose to go another direction, which is contrary to the will of God. The will of God is that you may get help, but the enemy stepped in. So, let's stop there, dear viewer, and God bless you so much. We will continue as time will allow. In next opportunity, there is always another opportunity. God bless you and God bless your day. Before I pray, I cannot fail to ask my dear viewer, someone that is there that needs to receive Jesus as his personal savior. It is only Jesus that can save your soul. It is not your brother. It is not your money. It is not your vehicle. It is not the riches that you are counting. It is only Jesus that can save your soul. And so I give you this opportunity so that you can receive Jesus and become a partaker of his blessings that we were talking about this morning. So why don't you join me and just repeat after me, because this is the only way.